Engineering has changed dramatically in the time since I graduated. The sciences and basic skills and techniques may be the same, but the way folks interact has changed considerably. You think about the role of engineers in engineering today, you think about solving energy problems, clean water, food supply, security, the big issues that are facing humankind. You don't think about engineers as fixing a bicycle. And that role of engineers in engineering is terribly important, and Lafayette creates a unique learning experience where that kind of engineer breathes and grows.
We wanted to look into how we could prevent falls. We surveyed a bunch of seniors to help us figure out what the older community would want in a brace. We sent it to the Lafayette Retirement Community and Meals on Wheels and the Easton Home. It was good to get what their feedback was and see what they really wanted so we could make something that they would actually use. So it gives them enough time to recover from the trip and gives them that extra force that they have, because as they get older, their ankles get weaker.
It's the job of the engineer to come through and very big picture get a sense and understanding of what the issues are and how we can best use our expertise to go ahead and solve them.
I knew I really liked the environment. I liked the idea of protecting it and then wanting to gain some technical skills to allow me to actually have an impact. The goal of this project is to make organic compost more competitive than inorganic compost. So sometimes with organic fertilizers, they end up putting all of the nutrients out at one time, but the plant only takes up a small percentage of that. So the rest of that actually ends up in our waterways. And although it's positive for plants, it can be really detrimental to the water.
I think one of the things that's important about a Lafayette engineer is the understanding and exposure of the humanities alongside of engineering. It makes them a better citizen, it makes them sensitive to the human condition, and it helps them understand the importance and the role that engineering plays in improving the quality of life.
The people that this wheelchair could benefit most are quadriplegics, or people who can move only their head. I like the idea of giving them back function that they lost or never had.
Well, I was high jumping, and immediately on takeoff, heard a big, loud crack. I had surgery the next morning where they put a titanium rod that goes inside your marrow cavity in your tibia. It was hard to be able to power myself forward, even though I could handle the pain of it. I'd just gotten off crutches, and I was having a really hard time walking up the stadium steps of Fisher Field. And I thought, wouldn't it be great if I just had something to give me a little bit of extra so I could get up the stairs and I could move about on my own? Theoretically, it could be used for muscular dystrophy patients, stroke patients, trying to rebuild some of those nerve connections. It'll build the muscle back, prevent some of that atrophy, and hopefully get you back to walking normal sooner.
I think engineering is helping people to make their life easier, or you can say more sustainable, or helping people to solve the problems.
The headset has a gyroscope, and we can use that to recognize if the user is turning their head. We map that to turning. And then we can also detect when you blink, so either to start the robot or stop it, or make it go forward or back. If the user closes their eyes for a certain period of time, tell the robot to do something else. Three actions, 3 degrees of freedom.
Coming from Lafayette, we were and are armed with the tools that we need to solve these problems that we have never seen before, but we can walk in with the confidence that we know that ultimately we can work together, come together, and come up with something amazing.
Through the course of my work, I've been exposed to hundreds of outstanding engineering schools, both in this country and abroad. But I can always think back to my experience at Lafayette and seeing what's happening now and how it's different. You're part of this broader community where you're not just among engineers or you're not just among students studying humanities. That's really important. It's important when you're working together and collaborating on solutions. It's important to learn from each other when you're sharing a cup of coffee. That's something that makes Lafayette unique and different, and the students coming out of there become better leaders and better citizens.
A really important thing that we learn as engineers is that we're gaining all these technical skills and we have specialized knowledge, and you earn respect with that, but with that respect comes a responsibility to problem solve things that can help people live more efficiently, more sustainably. And I think that Lafayette does a really good job of keeping the bigger picture, that is the true main focus of engineering.
The work you do directly influences society. This is what we do day in, day out, every single day I walk into the classroom.
we're immersed in engineering all around us. And then you add in this dimension of greater sensitivity to improving the quality of life for the 7 billion people on the planet, and you all of a sudden realize the role that engineers are going to play to improve the quality of life, to make sure that we can cohabitate this planet, whether we can address climate change or food supply or energy abundance. It's all going to be solved by engineers and engineering. And it's going to be Lafayette engineers who are going to be leading the way.